Hello everyone, here is a question from quantum mechanical model of atom. Calculate the de-Broglie wavelength of an electron that has been accelerated from rest through a potential difference of 1 kilo electron volt. We know that de-Broglie wavelength lambda is equal to h divided by p. H is the Planck constant and p is the momentum, and therefore this is equal to h divided by mv. We know the value of Planck constant, that is equal to 6.626 times 10 to the power minus 34 joule second, and the mass of the electron is 9.1 times 10 to the power minus 31 kg. What is the velocity of electron here? That is not given directly in this question. It is mentioned in an indirect manner, which we need to figure it out. What is mentioned in the question? An electron that has been accelerated from rest through a potential difference of 1 kilo electron volt. This means that when we don't apply any potential difference, the electron is at rest, and that means its velocity is zero, because we have an electron that is at rest. This means that velocity is zero. That means the kinetic energy of the electron is equal to zero. Now, after we apply the potential difference, the electron moves. So, when we apply the potential difference to the electron, now the electron moves. And that means it got some velocity that we need to find out. And this means that now it got kinetic energy, because any moving object with mass should have kinetic energy. And therefore, that is equal to half mv square. Therefore, we can equate the energy due to accelerating potential with the kinetic energy of the electron. Therefore, half mv square is equal to eb, because that kinetic energy, whatever the electron gets, is due to the potential difference that we are applying. Therefore, we can equate that eb is equal to half mv square. Therefore, mv square is equal to 2 eV, and if you multiply on both sides with m, we can write that mv whole square is equal to 2m eV. Therefore, mv is equal to square root of 2m eV, and this we can substitute here so that we can find out the lambda value. So let's find out this value of square root of 2m eV. Therefore, square root of 2m eV is equal to 2 times 9.1 times 10 to the power minus 31 kg times, here eV is mentioned as 1 kilo electron volt. This means this is equal to 1 times 10 to the power 3 times 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules, because the charge of an electron is equal to 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs, which multiplied by 1 volt gives this value. Therefore, 1 times 10 to the power 3 times 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules to the whole power 1 by 2. Let us work on the unit before we figure out what is the square root of 2m eV. In the numerator we have Planck constant, in the denominator we have square root of 2m eV. So here we have joule second, and here we have joules kg to the whole power 1 by 2, and therefore this will become joules to the power 1 by 2, kg to the power minus 1 by 2 second. We know that 1 joule is equal to 1 kilogram meter square per second square. So if we substitute that here, then what will happen? This will be kilogram to the power 1 by 2. Meter square to the power 1 by 2 will become meter. Per second square to the power 1 by 2 will become per second. And then this term we have kilogram to the power minus 1 by 2 and then second. So this will cancel out. This will also cancel out, and what would remain is only meter. That's what is going to be our unit. So now let us work on square root of 2 MeV. So here we have 10 to the power minus 31, here 10 to the power 3. So that will become 10 to the power minus 28. And then from 10 to the power minus 28, here we have 10 to the power minus 19. So that will be, if we add up, 10 to the power minus 47. And therefore, this is equal to, let us multiply 1.6 with 2. So 3.2 times 9.1 times 10 to the power minus 47 to the whole power 1 by 2. We can't take square root of an odd number. And therefore, let us multiply and divide by 10. So in that case, we can write that square root of 2 MeV is equal to 32 times 9.1 times 10 to the power minus 48 to the whole power 1 by 2. 32 times 9.1 is 291.2. And this will be 10 to the power minus 48 to the whole power 1 by 2. So that will become 10 to the power minus 24. We have 1 by 2 here. 17 times 17 is 289. And therefore, this will be approximately, we can write it as 17.1 times 10 to the power minus 24. So that's the value we have for square root of 2 MeV. Therefore, lambda is equal to 6.6 times 10 to the power minus 34 divided by 17.1 times 10 to the power minus 24 meter. So this we can write it as 66 times 10 to the power minus 35 divided by 17.1 times 10 to the power minus 24. Therefore, 66 divided by 17. So that will be 3 times will be 51, remaining 15. So price it to the decimal, and then 8 times will be 136. So approximately 3.8. And therefore, lambda is equal to 3.8 times 10 to the power minus 11 meter.